Let's consider a sequence of random variables, x1, x2, and so on, each uniformly distributed on an interval 0 to 1. Define Sn as the cumulative sum of the first n variables. Now, let big N represents the first time the cumulative sum exceeds 1. In other words, big N is the minimum value of n such that Sn is greater than 1. Our goal is to compute the expected value of S big N. Pause the video and give it a try, and when you're ready, keep watching. To compute the expected value of S big N, let's break it down step by step. The expected value of S big N can be written as the expectation of the sum of the first big N random variables. Expanding this further, we use the law of total expectation. Here, it becomes the sum of contributions from each possible big N. For big N equals to 1, we sum over x1 multiplied by the probability that big N equals to 1. For big N equals to 2, we sum over x1 and x2 multiplied by the probability that big N equals to 2. For big N equals to 3, we extend this pattern and so on. This gives us the general form. Let's examine specific cases for the stopping time big N. For big N equals to 1, since x1 is uniformly distributed between 0 and 1, it is impossible for x1 to be greater than 1. Therefore, the probability that big N equals to 1 is 0. Now let's move on to the case big N equals to 2. Here, the stopping time big N equals to 2 occurs if the sum of the first two variables exceeds 1. To visualize this, we consider the unit square, which represents all possible combinations of x1 and x2, each ranging from 0 to 1. The shaded triangular region within the square corresponds to the case where x1 plus x2 is less than or equal to 1. Therefore, we can compute the probability using the areas and get 0.5. For big N equals to 3, we extend the previous argument to the 3D space. The volume of the tetrahedron is 1 over 6, so we can compute the probability that a sum exceeds 1 by 1 minus the volume of the tetrahedron over the volume of the cube, which gives us 5 over 6. But we're not done yet. To get the probability that big N equals to 3, note that the sum cannot exceed 1 yet, when big N equals to 2. So the probability that big N equals to 3 is the conditional probability that the sum of the first three variables exceed 1, but the sum of the first two variables does not exceed 1. We can use the law of total probability to get the following expression. Note that if the sum of the first two variables already exceed 1, then the sum of the first three variables will of course exceed 1. So the middle term can be simplified as the probability that the first two variables sum to greater than 1. Finally, the probability required boils down to the probability that the sum of the first three variables exceed 1 minus the probability that the sum of the first two variables exceed 1, which is 5 over 6 minus 1 over 2, which gives us 1 over 3. We can extend this argument to higher values. For the case big N equals to k, note that the volume of the k-dimensional simplex, which is a triangle in 2D or a tetrahedron in 3D, is 1 over k factorial. Therefore, the probability that the sum of the first k variables exceeding 1 is 1 minus 1 over k factorial. We again use the law of total probability to get the following expression. And if the sum of the first k-1 variables exceed 1, then the sum of the first k variables must of course exceed 1, so we can simplify the middle term. It becomes the probability that the sum of the first k-1 variables exceed 1. Finally, we get the probability of big N equals to k is k-1 over k factorial. Now back to the original problem. Just like what we did at the start of the video, we can decompose the expected value of S big N into the sum from k equals to 1 to infinity of the expected value of Sk times the probability that big N equals to k. The expected value of each k is just 1/2. So the expected value of the sum is 1/2 times k. Then, we input the probability formula we have found into the equation as well. After some simplifications, we find that the answer is 1 over 2 times the sum from k equals to 0 to infinity of 1 over k factorial. This is actually the Taylor series expansion for E. So the final answer is 1/2 times E. As a follow-up question, can you prove that the volume of a k-dimensional simplex is 1 over k factorial? Check out the answer at the link in the description.